Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Locus. We are back with a familiar face on the channel, Mike. You've been playing this very cool deck for a little while now. Yeah, that's quite the success at this local with it.
Yes.
And I really wanted to showcase this deck. Zodiacs is a fan favorite deck. Really good this format. And anything you want to say before we go in?
Well, it was fun local. Went 4-0. Deck's pretty good still. I think we just go into the deck profile.
All right, cool.
That's standard Zodiac lineup. One red pier. Triple Whiptail, triple Doorblade, triple Ramram.
All right, so maxing out. No Bunny Blasts?
No, I couldn't find one. But
Joshua Osters was back.
Yeah. The thing is, I would definitely play one, just because we lost like two tankies.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's a bit more consistent if you have one extra name. So, and its effect is okay.
All right. Cool. So now the question, are there hand traps or are there a lot of spells?
No hand traps, just a lot of power spell and like...
Right. Gadarla?
Two Kaijus, one Pancratops. After local, maybe I want to play like an extra Kaiju, it's always really good. One mini match against Drytron, against PK and...
Yeah. Yeah, you tributed my Enforcer and I really wasn't ready for that.
So if game two, they will know and they will play around it. But game one, it's really, really good. And Pancratops.
All right. Nice.
To explain that. Then the spells, like for the one-offs, it's one Monster Reborn.
One Tanky.
One Tanky. One Feather Duster. You go second. Back row is really annoying, so Harpy's Feather Duster is really great. Two Cosmic Cyclone. You don't really want to pitch cards from your hand, so that's why I didn't want to play the Twin Twisters.
Yeah.
So it's really good, chainable against Order. So it helps a lot. And then we play Triple Lightning Storm as well.
The power cards, sorry.
Power card, yes. So, self-explanatory, destroys back row, destroys some monsters sometimes if they don't have any negates. Really, really good cards.
I think Storm is really good, this meta.
Yeah, it's good against Try, it's good against one negate boards when you can bait in the gate and then drop Lightning Storm. It's really powerful. Next card, Triple Mystic Mine.
Let's go.
This card is insane in this deck. When you bait something or they just don't have the gates, you drop Mystic Mine, then normal summon Zoo, make Corbo.
Yeah, I saw you play against Drytron. You like Kaiju the ultimate this, activated mine, GG, okay, yeah.
GG, yes, it's so good, he scooped immediately. So. Full combo with Mystic Mine, Dark Ruler No More.
Sick.
It's the best combo in the deck. Two card combo.
My Ruler, second.
It's a great card. Shuts down all like the important monster.
It's super
fields,
good to main this format, even in a non-gong second deck. So
yeah,
makes sense.
Then we played Triple Chalice.
All right, more popular card, as matter.
Yeah, exactly. You see it more and more often, and it's really good against Try and baiting the gate, so it's chainable your own turn. And since I'm blind second, it's really good.
You don't really want to play droplets in this deck.
No, you don't want to. You actually can't send the card. So this is. Meh. Sometimes it's really good and sometimes it's really bad. Would maybe cut this if I find something else, like an extra Kaiju, an extra Zodiac monster, and maybe a third Cyclone or something. But it's okay, like when it resolves, it's obviously broken, but it doesn't always resolve because your monsters don't...
trigger hand traps.
No, they don't really trigger hand traps, so... Therefore, it's meh. Triple pot, self-explanatory, draw two. You don't really care about what you banish in the deck, so all the cards are the same, like the monsters.
Yeah, exactly. No combo pieces.
No combo pieces. And then we played
Spicy.
One engage and triple eco booster. So the thing is, when they don't stop the normal summon, you can immediately make the Borbo in the extra monster zone. And when they try to imperm or something like that, the battle phase, you can always change this. And also when you like make Zeus, monster was like a Zeus, and then the Dino negate monster, and you try to negate the Zeus, and then you chain this, and it's, yeah, they can't really do anything about it. And when you have three spells in grave, what actually happens a lot, your monster can't be destroyed by battle. So it's really powerful, 3,000 Zeus, unaffected, undestroyable.
Yeah, you did this against me. I had like two Fogblade set, but it didn't matter because I knew you added one. So then you made the Borbo, I Fogbladed, you did that, and I was like, okay, yeah. Then you made Zeus,
yes.
I Fogbladed it again after the effect, and then you had another one, and I was like, okay, yeah, solid, solid.
Yeah, it's a fine card to draw multiples off as well. So
yeah.
That's okay. Extra deck.
Most complicated part of the deck.
Most complicated. Well, you see a lot of people play actually two Borbo, I like three. The thing is, this always makes Zeus. Well, you can always access Zeus with this card. So
yeah.
It's really good. Then I play two of each other one. You can make three Zeus with four materials exactly with this. So that was like the reason behind it. Summoning effect with this comes up sometimes. Reattaching as well. But you don't really need three of anyone.
All right.
Then I played two Vespanito. Vespanato, I don't know.
Despacito.
This is your first turn play. If they make you go first, it floats into another monster. Hopefully it's Ramram, and Ramram floats as well, so you have some kind of protection.
Yeah.
And if they don't out the third monster, you will you have a monster for Zeus.
Nice.
Pretty,
yeah.
Pretty okay. And then less, it's own it. It's not less XYZ monster. It's triple Zeus. It's Zeus.
It's the deck.
It's
yeah.
The deck. It's just boss monster, and then one of this one. It helps you clear your own board with some random stuff. Your opponent drops on you, and it's sometimes nice to
contact-y stuff like that.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Cool. Anything spicy in the side deck?
Well, maybe.
Little like, local dependence, probably.
Yeah, it is. We have a lot of back row decks at the local. That's why our main deck so many hate against it. Well, triple Lockbird, it's really good, this format. Triple Lancia, self-explanatory, it's really good. Really good card. Then the third Cyclone. Just for an extra back row removal. And then for the going first cards, we play trip of there's another back row removal card. It's really good in combination with Zeus, actually. Forgot about this one. Then triple DDG.
Oh, that's nice, yeah.
That's really good. It's chainable, it shuts down most of the decks for a whole turn, and then you can make Zeus the next turn. So.
Keep forgetting this card exists. It's so good.
It's so good. It's so good. Really, really worked. Really well. And then we played Sanctum Plecus.
Nice.
With Scythe. Of course. If they make you go first, you drop this, you can die.
They pass. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Alright. You do your shit. So.
Solid. So even with only one tanky, deck still doing great.
Yeah.
I mean, there's so many like easy win cons. You can steal so many games. It's very nice. All right, cool. Anything else you want to add to that?
No, I just want to thank you for coming to local again.
Yeah, I've been away at this local for 1 year. Happy I'm finally back. All right, cool. Thank you for the deck profile, and see you guys in the next one.